Hello, it's Friday, October 2nd, and as we work our way through the book of Acts in our devotional series, today we find ourselves at the close of chapter 14, and we're talking about Paul's first missionary journey. And we talked yesterday about how he went into these different cities and shared the gospel, starting with the Jews first and then taking it to the Gentiles, that some believed, and that many of the Jews rose up in rebellion against the truth of God's word. And now here in the closing verses of the chapter, we see that Paul and Barnabas revisit the cities. This first missionary trip of Paul is known as the fishhook journey because it literally looks like a fishhook or an upside down J. And so as we take a look at this last section here, we're remembered of how Paul and Barnabas go back to strengthen the believers that they had spoken to the first time that they visited. And now they're also going to elect elders in each of those congregations. And what an important role those elders play. You know, elders in a Christian congregation are wonderful gifts that God gives. They're men who have been raised up by God with the ability to serve in his kingdom in a way that encourages other Christians. And that's exactly the role that Paul is leaving these individuals with as he leaves as the missionary. He's got to entrust somebody to take care of the day-to-day ministry of the congregation, and so that falls upon the elders. In our Christian congregations today, the elders often work side by side with the pastor and actually help and assist him in carrying out his work as the shepherd of God's people. Sometimes that means that they make calls on behalf of the congregation to share God's word with somebody who might be in a hospital or somebody maybe who has not been in worship on a regular basis and needs some encouragement to make faithful use of God's word and the sacrament. And so we thank God for the gift of elders as he gives them to the members of his church, because they do fill a very important role. Because a pastor, well, he can only meet with so many people during the course of the week, and he can only do so much. But when we have elders and we spread that work out among the elders, much more ministry can be accomplished in the same time frame. And so we give thanks for that blessing. We read from Acts chapter 14, beginning at verse 21. After they preached the good news in that city and had gathered many disciples, they returned to Lystra, Iconium, and Antioch, strengthening the souls of the disciples and encouraging them to continue in faith. They told them, "We must go through many troubles on our way to the kingdom of God." They had elders elected for them in every church, and with prayer and fasting they entrusted them to the Lord, in whom they believed. When they had passed through Pisidia, they came to Pamphylia. When they had spoken the word in Perga, they went down to Attalia. From there they sailed back to Antioch, where they had been entrusted to the grace of God for the work they had just completed. When they arrived and called the church together, they reported everything God had done with them and how he had opened the door of faith for the Gentiles. Then they stayed there a long time with the disciples. What an amazing and wonderful report that they had to share, that God had opened the door for the Gentiles and that his gospel message was now to be promoted among every tribe and nation around the world, and that Gentiles were actually coming to faith in Jesus as the Savior and trusting in God's plan of salvation. We give thanks for that today as well, because most of us who live here in the United States, we would be considered Gentiles. We're non-Jews, and without Christ and without the mission to the Gentiles that the Lord established through the Apostle Paul and the other apostles, we would not have the truth of God's word. We would not be saved. But God has given us that wonderful gift, and he continues to raise up individuals who are willing to serve the Lord by serving others with the gospel ministry, taking to them words of comfort and admonishment as needed, sharing with them the truth of God's word. Some are pastors and teachers. Some are elders, like spoken of here in our reading today, who are willing to serve the Lord in any capacity upon which he calls them to serve. And we give thanks for those elders today. And let us pray. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the spiritual leaders that you raise up among us within our Christian congregations here on this earth. We especially give thanks to you for the elders that you bless our congregations with, men who are willing to carry out the gospel ministry, to share the gospel, words of encouragement, words of admonishment as needed, to guide the congregation in giving thanks for the many gifts that you have bestowed upon us, for being an aid to the pastor as he carries out his ministry under service to you. Oh Lord, we give thanks for all of these spiritual leaders that you have blessed us with and have placed in our life so that we might learn from them, so that we might grow in faith, so that we might be encouraged by them with the message they bring and the example that they give in their daily lives. Oh Lord, we thank you for these wonderful gifts that you give to your church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.